So now let's look at cycle 3. In cycle 3, we will try to issue the next instruction, which is this multiplication. We will look at whether we have a unit. Yes, we do. It's going to be a multiply instruction. F2 and F4 are LD2 and the actual value of F4. So here, we will mark the actual value of F4. This is our second operand as 2.5, because that's what this says. And then for the first operand, we will mark that we are waiting for LD2. This is going to make it very easy to determine which things are ready to execute, because the instruction should not really have anything here if it's ready to execute. And this instruction is not going to be ready yet because it's waiting for the second load. And then we're going to rename F0 so that it points to the reservation station, in this case ML1, that contains this instruction. In this third cycle, the first load is still executing. Now the question is, can the second load begin execution? If we have a pipelined load store unit, then yes, it would be, because in the previous cycle we have begun this instruction. It's in the second stage now, so now we can begin the first stage for this instruction. But let's say that we don't have a pipelined load store unit, that only our add unit is pipelined, in which case this load will not be able to dispatch into the execution unit until cycle 4, because basically the execution unit will be occupied in cycles 2 and 3 by the first load. So we will kind of mark that in cycle 4 we will be able to begin execution of this if everything else is ready. And nothing is still broadcasting the result. The first load is still executing in cycle 3. So now we go to cycle 4. In cycle 4, we will try to issue the next instruction, which is this subtract. It's going to use an adder unit. So this is just to mark it as a subtract. We're going to issue it in this cycle. F2 and F6 are LD2 and LD1. So this one actually is waiting like this. And we also have to mark the F8 as renamed to AD1. So this completes the issuing in this cycle. Now let's see if we can dispatch something. Well, this is cycle 4. In cycles 2 and 3, the first load has been executing. Now it's ready to write. So basically, we can begin execution of this instruction. So it's been dispatched in cycle 4. Now we no longer need this. Are any of the other instructions ready to execute? Well, not in this cycle. So now we're going to write the result in LD1. LD1 here, we kind of noted here that it's going to write the result in cycle 4, which is now. So now we're going to write to the result of this instruction. So we can mark here that we are writing that result. And what's going to happen now is basically it's going to broadcast with a tag of LD1 and the value we loaded from memory from this address. And that value is going to be put to F6. So what we do now is we're going to broadcast that value and capture that value everywhere where we have LD1 in this table. So each of these is going to compare its tag to LD1, and wherever we see an LD1, we're going to get that value. So in this case, only this particular instruction is going to latch that value. So let's say that the value is 7.1, okay? That completes the result capture. We still have to put 7.1 in the actual register F6. So somewhere in F6, we have 7.1 now, because this was pointing to LD1. LD1 is done now, so now we can find that value in the register file. And now we can free this reservation station. So when you free reservation stations, what you really do is you just turn off the valid bit for the entry. You don't really have to erase the whole entry. So I'm gonna erase it just to prepare for the next instruction, but keep in mind that in real hardware there is just a single bit that just gets marked to zero, and that is considered to free the reservation station. Now in this cycle, in cycle 4, we have issued an instruction, we have tried to dispatch an instruction, and we found that only the load really can be dispatched, and we have written our result back. Only one result can be written per cycle anyway, so that's it for this cycle. So let's move on to cycle 5.